And now we will learn the last part of setting up your QuickBooks Online, putting in items on the items list. An item, in this context, is a product or service that we buy or sell. This means that an item is something that we would list in the body of a receipt or the middle of an invoice. For example, let's imagine this is the invoice window in QuickBooks Online and we're filling out the invoice for one of our customers. We would have to put the quantity of the item in the invoice window, and all the other information about the item would come from the items list that we set up. Then all we have to do is click here for the pull-down list and choose an item, for example, apples, and the description and the price each would come up. QuickBooks would then multiply the quantity times the price that we set up for that item, and it would get us the total that we would have to pay. Apples are an example of a product item that we would put on an invoice or a receipt. On the same list that we're setting up, we could also set up services like video hours. And then once we chose video hours from the pull-down list that we're going to set up right now, QuickBooks would multiply the price that we set up on the list times the quantity that we put in the invoice to tell us the total that we have to pay. So it's very convenient to have an items list so that when we make an invoice or a receipt, we can just choose the item from the list and have QuickBooks do the rest of the work for us. The only thing we have to consider when we set up the items on the items list is making sure that the correct income account will increase when we put the specific item on the list. For example, if we put video item or video service on a receipt or an invoice, we want to make sure that the video income account is the account in the chart of accounts that records that invoice for that item of service. However, if instead we put another item on the list, in this case, editing service, we would want to make sure when we set up the editing item that if we put the editing item on a receipt or an invoice, that it is the editing income account that increases, not the video income. In other words, when you set up an item on the items list, it is not enough to put the name and put the price. You also have to tell QuickBooks which income account will record the income for that item. Now here we are at the dashboard homepage of QuickBooks Online, and to put an item on the items list, you go to the right and click the Setup cog. Then go over to the List column and click Products and Services. Of course, if it's the very first time you're coming to this window, you get this green button with this picture. So we click the green button so we can start putting in our services. This item is not a product, it's a service. So we will click Service, and now we have the data fields to put in the service. There are several that you can explore and experiment with on your own time, but we will only put the name as video. Okay? We will put the sales price and rate as 300, and the only other piece of information that's required is the income account. When we click the arrow, we get our chart of accounts. The income account that should increase when we do a video service will be video income. And again, you could put additional information as well as a picture if you want to explore and experiment with extra data fields on your own time. But for this course, all we need is the name, price, and income account. When we click Save and Close, we see that we now have a list instead of that green button. These two items are items that QuickBooks Online already set up for us. And we will ignore and disregard these and put the other item that we will use. While we're in the products and service lists, we click New. And again, this is a service. The name is editing. Well, I like to make it in capital. It's nice. Editing. And of course, the rate is $140 an hour. And the income account for editing is not video income. The income account for editing is editing income. This way, when we put the editing item on a receipt or an invoice, the money that comes in from that service will be recorded in this particular account. Save and close. And now we have the two services that we put and the other two services that QuickBooks Online put. And now our QuickBooks Online is set up and ready for our first transaction.